In this video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Supabase account to be able to use it as a vector store database within n8n. So here I have a very simple workflow. I am click trigger. I've got a document with some information that I'm going to be putting into my Supabase vector store. All right, in order to do that, what we're going to do is you set up a Supabase node. We're going to come down here, create new credentials. And so I need to set up Supabase. Now I'm going to do that from scratch to show you how it's done. So I'm going to come over here to another email address I have. So we're going to start my project. All right. We're going to put in my email. I guess I have to sign up. Let's go ahead and sign up. We're going to do mayfloweradvising.com. Really quick, let me set up a password and I will be right back. Okay, there we go. I'm gonna log in. I have to check my email to confirm. There's the email, confirm my email. It's gonna want me to log in again. And I guess it didn't ask for my, okay. So we'll just call this Mayflower Advising, why not? I'll just give it a name. Personal is the type, sure, whatever. Set it up for free, and they give you a ton of room for free. So no reason to set up, unless you're already planning on scaling this, don't just set it up for free to see how it works. Great organization. Okay. And there we go. Now we are set. We need to create a new project. So I need to give it my password. And we are not in Virginia. I am in Los Angeles. Let's see. West. Okay, there we go. All right, create new. And that is about it. That's how you set up the project. Now we actually have to go in and create a table. So to do that, let's head back to n8n real quick. Okay, here we are back in n8n. Now I could set this stuff up, but I wanna show you how to create the table first and then we'll come and do the credentials. So you might, while you're in Supabase, you might as well set up Supabase to be able to use it. So we're gonna open our documentation here. We come over here to the documentation. We're actually looking for a Supabase vector store. I'm going to click on that. And then down here, if you scroll down, it says Supabase provides a quick start for setting up your vector store. I'm going to click that. And you see all this code here? This is what we want to start. And I'll explain it just a little bit in just a second. I'll go ahead and copy this little, or push the button here to copy it. We're going to go back to Supabase. We're going to come over to the left side here, where it says SQL editor, click on that. New SQL set snippet, there we go. You paste this in. Now what this is doing, broad strokes, I don't really understand code, but what it's doing is it's adding in the vector extension to this table so that now your Supabase account is gonna be able to do vectors. It's creating a table for you. In this case, it's called documents. Now if you want a different name, you need to change the name documents anywhere it says documents in here. Otherwise, it's not gonna be the right table. It's also creating a function to be able to search that table called documents. So you need this to match, so this match function here, to match the name of the table that you're creating. It's good enough to start with documents. Might as well, what you're gonna do is you hit run down here. We got an error for documents. Why did I get an error for document? Like it's the code. ID, big serial number, primary ID, run. I ran that time. Nothing, I didn't change anything. All right, well it ran. And we can see over here, if we come over to table editor on the left, come over here, click there. We now have a table and it's set up to be able to take vector embeddings. All right, so from here, now we're gonna get our credentials to be able to connect it to n8n. Okay, here in n8n, we see that we need a host and a service role secret. So let's go back to Supabase. We're gonna come over here to the left side. We're gonna come down to project settings, click that. Now you close out that window on the left, you'll see here on the left under project settings, we have a tab called API keys. Go ahead and click that. All right, so we see here the service role secret. So at least we have that, but where's the host? Now, there might be better ways of finding it, but the way I found it is you come up here to this button that says connect, click that, come over to app frameworks, click that, And then you'll see down here under this says next public Supabase URL, you have this URL right here. We're gonna grab that, copy it, and that's gonna be our host. So we come back over to n8n, paste that in, then come back to Supabase, close this window, reveal your secret. And again, never, ever, ever share your secrets with anybody ever. In fact, it looks like it's basically the same, but never share your secrets. I'm gonna delete this account as soon as we're done. Come over to n8n again, paste this in here, save it. You're gonna get green. Green means it's connected. Good, we are good to go. So now if we come over here to our table list, we can select a table. We'll pick documents. Good, let's go ahead and save it. And then we're gonna go ahead and run it. And then we'll check the table to see what it was able to upload. So it's pulling from my document. It's uploading and doing its embeddings. There we go. Hopefully there's not too many. There appears to be a few. All right. Anyway, we can go back to Supabase while it's doing that. Come over to the table editor and we'll see that the table now has data in it. It's got the content from my document in here, all the different kinds of workflows that I make. It's got a metadata as well as the embeddings right here. And so that's not gonna, there we can. We can expand it out. And so there you go. You now have your very own vector store. It's usable right here within n8n. We're gonna go ahead and stop that. You're gonna stop because you're going too many times, man. All right, if you found this video helpful, please make sure to like and subscribe to the channel. Please make sure to like the video and share it. If you want additional helpful n8n tutorials, or if you'd like a ton of free workflows, please join my free school community. We've got social media posting bots, we've got lead scrapers, executive assistants, and so much more. It's all available in the link below in my free school community. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.